Here in Philadelphia, tonight it's the first of four between the Arizona Diamondbacks and the Philadelphia Phillies. These two should provide some big-time fireworks. First pitch is coming up. Giovanni Gallardo will be on the mound for the series opener. EK, what do you got?
Well, guys, you take a look at that ERA. He has not been good this year. Got to throw a lot better. Hopefully he can start doing that in this one.
A.J. Pollock
heads for the batter's box, and we are just about ready for some leading evening for baseball.
Center fielder, A.J. Pollock.
And the first pitch of the night here is taken for ball one, and we're officially underway in Philadelphia. These Phillies, Eric Karros, as they enter play here tonight. Despite that loss last time out, they're still on a pretty nice run as they'd won six in a row prior to that.
And they've got themselves a pretty good sized lead in the division coming into play. Certainly not out of reach yet, but they've got to be pretty comfortable with where they're sitting at this point in the year.
Three and oh now, showing some uncharacteristic wildness to start things out.
Yeah, four pitch walk, pretty much not the way you want to start out against a club like this.
And that misses as well, so that might portend some trouble tonight as he begins the game with four wide ones.
In the second spot tonight, the left fielder number five,
Ender Inciarte, will stand in now, and as you can easily tell from the splits, he's really struggled away from home. Runner goes for second. Pitch inside, the throw. Short hop, but they got him. Great pick and tag to catch him trying to steal.
The best way a pitcher can slow down the running game is vary his moves. Hold the ball, throw to first, show your best move to first, or slide step. The guy tried to steal on a slide step right there. The chances are you're going to be out, and they nabbed him.
Here's a swing and a high pop-up, drifting toward the third base dugout. And this is taken in by Beltre for the second out. Time now to look at the Diamondbacks' starting lineup. What's the key for them to win this series opener, Steve?
Well, you're thinking that you might be able to score runs today in this ballpark and against this pitcher. So you need to get on top and then just don't let that foot off the pedal. Keep it going because no lead is safe here.
Paul Goldschmidt gets his first opportunity now in the top of the first with nobody on. Gallardo gets the sign. First pitch on its way. Here's a slider to start things out. Looked at for ball one. You got to figure that that man right there would be more than happy to see this guy at the plate taking his swings with two out and nobody on all night long.
So would the guy on the mound.
Not close. It's 2-0. You still come after him now on 2-0?
I think you have to be a little careful, but yeah, I don't think you can just give up on him.
From the windup, the 2-0 pitch. Swing and a liner. Foul. Just getting started here in Philly. He's fallen behind now, 3-1. And set up behind the dish is Gary Simmons, as you see the rest of our umpiring crew there.
Well, some call Simmons a pitcher's umpire because he's been known to have a wide zone at times, but I think he evens it out, to be honest with you. Pretty fair overall.
Swing and a line drive, but this will be a foul ball. Something has to give. Here's the payoff pitch. Got him swinging, and that will end the inning. Diamondbacks down without much of a fight. Now it'll be the Phillies' turn. No score. Marcus Stroman, a right-hander from the Empire State, gets the starting assignment here. EK, what's the word on him?
Well, remember, guys, he's a young pitcher, still garnering a lot of experience, and he has a lot of upside. If he continues to improve, he's going to be around this league for a very long time. I can't wait to watch him in this one.
Heading for the batter's box now is Drew Stubbs, as he'll start things out in the home half of the first. First pitch is a breaking ball, taken down and away for ball one. EK, you take a look at this Diamondback ball club as they begin play here tonight. They come in looking to make it two in a row as they were winners last time out.
And the thing about baseball is that each new day brings a new opportunity. So we'll see if these guys are up to the task here.
And that pitch misses in the dirt, and it's 2-0 now.
Well, not close on either of these first two pitches. He's going to have to find the release point quick before he loses the leadoff guy.
Swing and a miss on the heater, and it's 2-1.
Yeah, and in a good hitter's park like this one, it's going to be even more important than usual to keep that fastball down. That's right where he's got to be living.
Hit the other way out toward right field. This is taken in by Trumbo, and there's out number one. A moment now to check out the hometown Phil's starting lineup. What's this club need to focus on here this evening, Steve?
Well, they're facing a guy today that throws a lot of strikes, so you're going to have to be aggressive early in the count, but get the ball up in the zone. Shorten up a little bit, put the ball in play.
Brock Holt will stand in, and he wasn't much of a factor yesterday as he took an 0 for 4 in the loss.
Well, baseball can be a humbling game. Yesterday wasn't a good day for him, but over the season, he's hitting over 300.
The fastball here is he'll take a look at ball one, 1-0.
One thing about our two starters, they'll both light up the radar gun all game long.
And this is a fastball that's right on the black but ruled a ball. It's 2-0 now. Bases are empty, one man out. Down low, and the plot thickens here, 3-0. From the windup, the 3-0 pitch. And there's a strike as he'll try to work his way back. It's 3-1. With that one, it's ball four. A one-out walk here in the home first.
Batting third, the shortstop.
Mikel Franco will dig in. Currently fifth in the National League in batting to begin play.
And he's right up there among the RBI leaders, too, so he's dangerous with runners on base.
Runners off for second. Hit hard up the middle. Reined in. In time to first, and there are two away. And with that, let's bring in a look at the defensive alignment for the Diamondbacks. It's brought to us by Majestic. Any thoughts, Eric?
Well, guys, we have an opportunity to watch one of the most underrated players in the game today, Ender Inciarte. Most people don't appreciate how good of an outfielder he is. He's got great speed, and that speed allows him to cover a ton of ground. Takes away a lot of potential base hits. We'll see if he does that here in this one.
He's set. Here it comes. Swing and a little tapper. That rolls foul for strike one. boy, big problems here to start this at bat. It's 0-2 now.
And you know, all you have to do is point back to yesterday's ball game. This was part of their downfall, hitting with runners in scoring position. They just couldn't sustain any kind of offense. So this would be a big boost if he could turn the tide a little bit here and come through big.
And he missed with it. It's 1-2.
He showed him that slider running away two times in a row. Now might be a good time to call in that two-seamer running in.
High fly ball out to straightaway center. Pollock moves over. And that retires the side. Phillies strand one after one, no score. Mark Trumbo steps in hoping to get things going at the plate. Arizona. You can see it's been a bit of a struggle for him in recent games.
Mark Trumbo.
Second inning 1-0. Begins with a slider that misses here. It's 1-0. That's inside. 2-0.
And this is all about handling a guy like this with kid gloves. You know, walk him if you have to, but don't let him be the one to beat you.
And he gets the slider over here. It's 2-1 now.
And even though that's a strike, that's a good take. You want to be looking one pitch, one spot. So don't go swinging at that one. That was nasty.
Gallardo sets his sights. Here's the 2-1. And they set up away with the fastball, but it misses. 3-1.
They already walked one guy in the first inning. Now he's in danger of losing the leadoff guy here in the second.
And that misses for ball four. So it's a leadoff walk here to start the second.
Yeah, and this has been the big concern with this guy over the last couple seasons. He's prone to getting hurt by the base on balls. Already that's two walks here in the early going. And that's something that he's going to need to get a handle on pretty quick.
Rafael Vasquez gets his first shot here with a man on following the leadoff walk.
And you know, guys, we talk about it all the time. Leadoff walks are so dangerous. And we'll see if they can take advantage of this one.
From the stretch. And there he goes towards second. That's yanked into the stands. Strike one. He's ready. Here's the 0-1. Very weakly on the ground, but it gets foul. Grounded back up the middle. He'll go to the bag for one. On to first, and they get the double play. With a moment now, let's take a look at how the Phillies will set up on D. It's brought to us by Majestic. Eric, what do we need to know?
Well, guys, remember, this manager has not jumped on board with all the defensive shifts. Still that old-school mentality, plays guys straight up. So we'll see how that impacts this game.
Andres Cordero will stand in, and as you can see, the numbers away from home, he's been much better once he gets out on the road. Swing and a liner, but foul. That misses wide. One ball and one strike.
And he's tracking that all the way across the plate, but that had too much sweep to it for him to think of swinging.
No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. All away here to start the at bat.
And that's fine, but you can't be afraid to work inside. You can jam this guy, get him to roll over something. You don't have to strike him out.
Reached for and popped into the air back behind second. And Franco will make the catch to retire the side. Nothing doing for Arizona. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. Adrian Beltre will stand in now. 0 for 4 in that day game yesterday.
Well, that was a rough one yesterday, but he's still hitting over 300 in his last 10 games.
Started to go around, but it's ruled strike one anyway. And, oh, look out! Up and in and nearly took his head off.
Huh. Safe to say, guys don't care much for that location. That'll get you riled up the plate, no doubt.
Here's the one-and-one delivery. Drilled right back up the middle. And this is going to get on through into center, a leadoff hit.
Yeah, he hit a good pitch there. This thing's toward the outside part of the plate, but he stays with it all the way. Uses the big part of the field and gets himself a base hit.
Salvador Perez will stand in, and you see what he's done over the past four games, as hot as they come. And he gets ahead here with the fastball, strike one. Hit hard to short. One there. On to Goldschmidt, a double play.
Batting seven.
Well, this ball is hit sharply, but you'll see the pitch is working its way down in the strike zone, and that's very tough to elevate. It's going to wind up being an easy double play ball.
Darren Ruff will stand in, and as you check out his righty-lefty splits, no surprise that he hits better against the southpaws than he does against right-handers. Into the windup and the pitch. Ouch.
Start a streak somewhere, and he's well into this one now. A six-game hit streak with that base hit. He's swinging the bat pretty good right now.
Freddy Galvis will stride in now. Back in the lineup after being limited to pinch hit duties in yesterday's ball game. First pitch here misses wide, 1-0. And a strike to even the count, 1-1.
Yeah, and this really is his 1-2 punch. He's got both the two-seamer and the cutter in his arsenal, so they're fairly similar pitches, except for the fact that one works its way in, the other one works its way out. Very effective, especially when you double up and throw one off the other.
Pitch, a curveball that's off the catcher's glove and gets away. And he'll make it into scoring position here with two away, as that'll be scored a wild pitch.
And this inning was going nowhere. All of a sudden, though, it's changed dramatically. A base hit, a wild pitch. Now, just like that, there's a runner in scoring position.
Bottom of the second here with no score. chopped foul wide of first. Hit to short. Owings is there. Throw in time and the side is retired. One left for Philadelphia. We'll move to the third with no score. Chris Owings leads it off here. Bottom third of the order set to go here in the third.
Well, he's faced the minimum so far, and obviously it's still early, but they need to get something going because you can't let this guy settle in out there.
First pitch of the inning is taken downstairs for a ball. It's 1-0. In for a strike, it's 1-1. In there, 1-2 now.
So tough to hang in there on that pitch, but you gotta do it. You can't give up that inside corner, or this guy will eat you alive.
Still 1-2 as he fouls it away. And that misses 2-2.
Yeah, I think you have to ask yourself, was he trying to throw a fastball for a strike right there? Or was he just trying to set me up for that changeup away?
A full count, three balls and two strikes.
Now this one sets up a big pitch because you don't want to lose that leadoff guy in a scoreless ballgame.
Fights off another pitch and hits it foul right at the plate. Locked in a good battle. Here comes another one. To short. Franco has it. Throw to first in time, and the leadoff man is gone to start the third.
Batting eight, second baseman, Cesar Hernandez.
Into the box, Cesar Hernandez. He'll get to take his first cuts here. And he tries to hold back on the swing, but I think it would have been ruled a strike anyway. It's nothing and one. Up the middle and off the pitcher's leg. Unable to recover, he's safe at first, and now the attention turns back to the guy on the mound. And with that play over now, time to check and see if our man is all right. You can really see him favoring that leg, and that is his plant leg, which is always a concern, but from the way he's acting out there, I think it looks like he's going to be okay to try and continue. The pitcher, Marcus Stroman, steps up to the plate in a sacrifice situation, so let's see if that is indeed on right here.
Textbook sack situation here, guys.
Showing bunt here, but he takes ball one.
And you know, I've always thought, if you're pretty sure a guy might be trying to bunt, then put that first pitch out of the strike zone. Make him show you his intentions. Maybe you get him to offer it something that he shouldn't.
Gallardo pauses. Here it is on 1-0. Tries to get the bunt down here, but this is foul, and we'll see if he tries it again. Runner at first here, one man out. And they'll try to stay out of the double play here as he lays this one down. The second for one. On to first as they get the double play to get him out of the inning. One hit in the inning, but no one left. We'll head now to the home half of inning number three. And we are tied nothing-nothing. Giovanni Gallardo digs into the box in the bottom of inning number three.
Pitcher, Giovanni Gallardo.
First pitch on its way. Too high, 1-0. Inside, and he falls behind the hitter now, 2-0.
I gotta think he's gonna leave the bat on his shoulder again here, even 2-0. This approach hasn't been too sharp so far to lead off the inning.
And wow, that looked to be well inside, but it's a called strike. 2-1 now. High strikes, probably not on the docket for places he wants to be.
Yeah, I mean, it's no secret. You've got to keep the ball down against a team like this. If you go up every once in a while with a fastball, you'll be fine. But you're not going to last too long if you make a habit of working up there with your secondary pitches.
Now the fastball is right by him as he swings and misses for the first out of the inning.
Now he was really late on this one. I mean, really late.
Now batting.
You can see where the baseball is by the time he gets the barrel through. I mean, it's darn near in the catcher's glove already. That tells me he was probably looking for something else.
Here's Drew Stubbs now. As he'll take a look at a slider here that finds the zone for strike one. Cut a little too much, a ball and a strike.
And if he can get himself into a fastball count, don't be surprised if he has a big cut at something. Maybe try and break this tie ball game.
Ready with the 1-1 pitch. And he lays off for a ball, 2-1.
Well, this is a spot where it helps to have a two-seam fastball like that so you can work in on the right-handed hitters.
Bottom of inning number three, 0-0 our score. Hard hit ball to second, and this will get through into right, and he's aboard with a single.
A pretty good swing there. You watch, head stays down, ball gets deep in the zone, and he lets those hands lead the way, and he drives it to right field. That's as good an approach as you're going to see.
Here's Brock Holt now. Lying towards center field. In there, a base hit. Long throw to third. And he is in there.
I've got to say, even as a right-handed hitter myself, there's something about a left-handed hitter's swing. It's really fun to watch when they square one up. This is a cut fastball, but you see the nice extension, the good follow-through, and he just rips it into center field.
Standing in now, Michael Franco. Yes, he'll take a tough pitch on the outside part of the plate for strike one.
Well, you know, you hear it all the time because it's true. First pitch strikes are so important. It really changes the complexion of the at-bat for not only the pitcher, but the hitter as well, especially when you've got a good hitter up there.
That's on the inside corner to put him behind here, 0-2.
And now, with runners at the corners and two strikes, this is a spot where you've got to make something positive come out of this on the mound.
Has to be thinking strikeout here. And a fastball in the dirt that's taken for a ball.
And even on 1-2 now, you've got to expand the strike zone a little up there. You can't go down looking here. You've got to put this ball in play.
Runners are at first and third, one away. To two balls and two strikes now.
That's a good idea, one and two right there, just to see if he'd chase. But now with the count even, I think this one has to be in the strike zone because you don't want to run the risk of loading the bases for the cleanup guy.
Just out in front of that one, still 2-2. Good swing on a tough pitch, and he'll stick around to see another one. And the slider misses here, so he runs the count full, 3-2. EK, where are you going now on 3-2?
I still got to work a corner. Not just going to throw it right down the middle and grab a strike. Can't be a giveaway pitch.
Skied into straightaway right. Trumbull shading to his right. He's there to make the catch, and here comes the runner from third as this should get him on the board. The runner from third crosses the plate, and they've taken a 1-0 lead.
Well, they were looking for at least a sack fly here. Fortunately for them, they had the right man for the job at the plate. So nice work to come through and drive home an important run.
Brandon Jordan is at the plate now. Flied out in his first at-bat.
And that's just not really his game. Anytime he keeps it on the ground, he's got a pretty good chance of beating out a hit.
Behind on that one, now behind in the count, 0-1. Down the third baseline, but this will get foul for strike two. In the dirt here, and he is safe at second, and the wild pitch here could prove costly with two away.
Yeah, you know, right now he's just holding on to that curveball just a little too long. This is about a 58-footer, and once it skips away, he's going to make it up to second easily.
Runner in scoring position at second with two down.
Nope.
Tries to get him to chase the curveball away, but it breaks outside. 2-2 now.
And when he's down 0-2, he's smart enough to know guys are going to try and get him to chase. So now at 2-2, he's got himself back to a spot where he doesn't have to go after a pitcher's pitch.
Still 2-2. He's set. Here's the 2-2. This one misses, and that'll fill the count here. 3-2 with two away.
Boy, nothing's really come easy for him so far on the mound. He's had to work for everything, and now he's got to deal with another full count.
Ready now with the payoff pitch. A little bouncer. Throw won't get him at first, an infield single, and it's first and third now.
Oh, you talk about being comfortable at the plate. That's the way he's feeling it right now. Nine straight games with that base hit now.
Adrian Beltre stands in with two on and two out here in the third.
And you know, some guys just get better with runners in scoring position and two outs. This is a big at-bat for him right here, even though it's still early.
And he's back standing. Fastball a bit too low here. It's ball one.
His pitch count is really spiked here in the inning. He's up over 50 already.
Went about halfway there, but it's a called strike regardless. This is line to left. In there. Base hit, and that ought to get the run in from third. And now time is called here as their pitching coach is going to pay a quick visit to the mound to discuss how they want to attack things here. Salvador Perez steps into the box and we'll see what he can do here. Two on, two away, two home in the inning so far.
Well, this could be a huge inning or maybe the end of the inning. This is a pivotal at-bat in one of the turning points of this ballgame right here.
First pitch of the at-bat on its way. Swung on and missed that time. It's 0-1. That's in there, and he's deep in the hole now, 0-2. Seems like he's gotten away with more than a few location mistakes so far.
Yeah, and that's not going to last forever, especially in this place.
Nothing in two count, and the pitch. Ripped on the ground to first, and he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. I have to imagine there's a full moon tonight, judging by this bunch. More in a moment on the show, the Friday Night Showcase. Leading off the inning, A.J. Pollock, as they'll look to get something going here and even this game up.
And right here is an important time for them to climb back into this one. They definitely want to even this one up sooner rather than later.
He'll try to bunt his way on as he gets this one down. Beltre is there, but the throw will beat him at first, so the bunt for hit attempt is snuffed out.
Well, maybe not a terrible idea to drop one down, but I'll tell you what. When you've got a pitcher out there looking for a shutdown inning, the last thing you want to do is make an out on the very first pitch. But that's what he gets.
Ender Inciarte in now, popped out in his first trip.
Yeah, he just uppercut a fastball. That top hand kind of dragged through the zone, which caused the bat head to drop a little bit.
Trying to bunt his way on base here, but this will roll foul. Bounce towards the second baseman. Fielded by Galvis. On to first, and that is two quick outs to start the fourth.
First baseman number 44, Paul Goldschmidt.
So bases are empty here with two gone. And stepping in, the power-hitting first baseman, Paul Goldschmidt. Into the seats, 0-1. Gallardo's ready. Here he comes, 0-1.
Nope.
That's over, but low. It's a ball and a strike.
Still a little bit early to be worrying about this, but in a two-run game, a two-out walk here would at least get the tying run to the plate. And on top of that, this guy has some pop.
No runs, just one hit. No errors so far for the Diamondbacks. And this one runs a little too far in, ball two. Turned on that one and crushed it. Just pulled it a little foul. Trying to strike him out for the second time. And another foul ball. Two out, nobody on. Hard liner towards short. And that's in there, so perhaps some life here with two men out.
Boy, that hit right there is just a thing of beauty. You talk about smoking one right back at the box. There isn't too many guys in the middle of that field that can catch a ball like that.
Mark Trumbo will get a shot here with two away and a runner at first now following the base hit.
That two-out single seemed harmless enough, but anytime you extend the inning to allow this guy to get a shot with a runner on, you better be careful.
Throw over to first. Throw is up the line as it gets away.
Well, this is going to hurt any way you look at it, but as you look at the replay, the thing to notice here is that guy, he's got no lead at all over there. I mean, he's maybe 5 feet off the bag. I know you want to keep him close, but come on.
First offering on its way. Swing and he pops him up over toward foul territory. And he'll get under it to put it away in foul territory, and that ends the inning. A golden opportunity to get on the board here goes for naught. We're back to Friday Night Baseball on the show after this. Darren Ruff is set to lead us off in the home half of the fourth inning.
And they jumped out to that early lead, so now it's all about just adding on.
Here comes the first pitch. Cut fastball taken for strike one. Swing and a liner, but this is a foul ball. The 0-2 delivery. Down and away, it's a ball and two strikes. And a good take there. Close, but it's 2-2.
And the hope was that he would have chased one of those pitches, but now on 2-2, I don't think you fool around anymore.
He's ready with the 2-2 pitch. And a good bite to that slider as he swings through it for the first out of the inning.
Yeah, and there are some times where you characterize a pitch as a sweeping slider, but this one does not fall into that category. This is a nasty little break at the end. Tough to do anything with that.
Stepping in now, Freddy Galvis. As he'll go after the first pitch and bounce one foul for the first strike. One out, nobody on. Hard hit ball to second. Hernandez is up with it, on to first, and there are two down.
The pitcher, number 50. Giovanni Gallardo.
Stepping in, Giovanni Gallardo. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up.
Yep, they sent him back in last time, so maybe they have a pretty good idea of how to attack him again right here.
And here's a first pitch curveball that bounces on him there. It's ball one. Can't connect there on the breaking ball. One and one.
Yeah, just really jumping out at that last pitch. He had him thinking fastball, maybe even slider.
Bases are empty here with two men out. A little behind on that swing, and now he'll try to shorten up maybe and protect the plate. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. Good job to spoil that one away, and he stays alive. Two out, nobody on.
Ball
He reaches for one but can't find it as he's down on strikes for the final out. Three up, three down for Philadelphia as they're unable to add to their 2-0 lead. Rafael Vasquez heads for the box to start off the fifth in this one.
And in a pretty close game so far, they'd love to see this guy get on base so they can get a rally started to get back in this thing.
Gallardo into his motion. Here's the first pitch. He slaps that one away, and the count will be nothing and one. Tries to shave the corner with that pitch, but it's one and one. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Three and one now.
Oh, I think he'd be real happy with a leadoff walk. Something just to get things started against this guy.
Here comes the 3-1 pitch. Right side hit hard. And that is through into right field for a single.
Just a 3-1 challenge right there. Fastball, middle in, and he takes a direct route to this thing and drives it for a knock.
Into the box now, Andres Cordero. He'll try to take control of the inside part of the plate with the fastball as he backs him off a bit.
Yeah, you got to be careful there after that leadoff single. You don't want to hit a guy here and really let him get something started.
Hey. And he fires in a strike this time to make it one ball and one strike. Well, that pitch isn't going to light up the radar gun, but it's been effective.
Well, it doesn't have to. If you get that good movement and put it in the right spot, it's plenty good enough to do the job.
Shot toward right center, and that'll get down for a base hit.
Now batting. Shortstop.
Chris Owings. Chris. Stand in now with two on here and nobody out to begin the inning.
And on the mound, he hasn't found himself in too many rough spots so far, so this might be his first real test of the ballgame.
First pitch of the at-bat. And he takes a cold strike, 0-1.
Well, this guy has thrown a first pitch strike to about 50% of the batters he's faced. He's pitching well, but those numbers could be pumped up a little bit.
No runs, four hits. No errors so far for the Diamondbacks. That's taken. Now it's 0-2.
Yeah, and it seems like he kind of got away from that pitch here in the last few innings. You got to think about bringing that one right back.
Ready with the 0-2. Now a swing and a ball popped high in the air over toward foul ground. One away.
And now that would have fallen under the infield fly rule if it was a fair ball. But no matter, he goes over to make the catch here in foul territory.
In now, Cesar Hernandez. As he'll take a look at a pitch too low, it's ball one. won't bite at that one either. It's 2-0.
He's in a situation now where he does not want this game to get away from him. Two guys on already. Now he's not in the strike zone to this hitter. He's got to reel it back in because you're flirting with a little bit of danger now with another ball.
The 2-0 pitch. And he gets this fastball over. It's 2-1. A pretty dangerous spot for that one.
I don't think it was by design. It's one thing to miss your spots out of the zone, but when you miss in the zone, especially up, that's when you tend to get hurt.
He's set, and the 2-1 pitch. That's going to even up the count at 2-2. And this misses, so that'll fill the count at 3-2. High in the air out to center field. Stubbs is there, and that's the second out of the inning.
Now batting, pitcher, Marcus Stroman.
Marcus Stroman digs in, and we'll see what he can do here with two on and two out here in the fifth.
Yeah, a couple of ducks on the pond out there looking to make that trip home. This is a big two-out AB right here, guys.
Line drive to left, and that's in there. Base hit. And a relay home. A tag from Perez. He's out at the plate. Diamondbacks strand a pair. They trail it here 2-0. Drew Stubbs comes to the plate as we get started here in the bottom of the fifth. A couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen.
Drew Stubbs.
Outside target here, and he hits it for strike one. And he falls behind 0-2. The windup and the 0-2 pitch. Scorched to third. And he'll reach to start the inning as this ball gets through him, a base hit.
Yeah. A hot shot that time and a tough read down there at third base. He just couldn't get the leather on it.
Brock Holt digs in. He reached on a single and would later wind up scoring in his last at-bat. Drops in a strike to start the at-bat, nothing and one.
And you know, this is a guy that loves the ball down and in. It's one of the locations he really covers well, so they're going to want to mix their spots here.
The 0-1. Inside with the slider, and that'll back him up a bit.
I think he was trying to get that slider in on his hands, but I don't think he meant for it to get in that far. I think he just released it a little too late.
He's set. Here comes the 1-1. There goes Stubbs. Ran one in on him there as this is hit softly to third. And taken in out there for the first out.
Yeah, and here with the runner who's on the move, you've got no chance of even thinking about getting the double play. So a smart idea there just to take the sure out at first.
Michael Franco will stand in for the third time now, still without a hit, so that streak could be in a bit of jeopardy.
And I think that's in the back of his mind, but it's not something he's really focused on. He just wants to get up there and put a good swing on the ball.
On his way to pitch number 75. Here's the first pitch slider that just tails out of the zone. It's ball one. One out and a runner on second base.
strike.
Inside corner, a ball and a strike. And he takes one off the inside corner for ball two.
Yeah, and on 2-1 right now, you gotta figure this guy's wound up for the fastball here. Maybe you come with the breaking ball here out of the zone and hope he goes after it.
Ready to deal. Here's the 2-1. Hot shot to third. And a sliding try there at third, but it skips by him, a base hit. And they won't risk it at third, so they're at the corners now with only one away.
Ah, the perils of being a third baseman. I remember it well. He's way out in front of this pitch and just hammers it towards the hole. And you can see by the reaction at third, the coaches are telling you, hey, get in front of that one. Yeah, right. You get in front of that one.
First things first, here's a throw over. And he'll get back in standing.
Just checking.
Into the box, Brandon Jordan. And a breaking ball in the dirt that time for a ball. Base hit, and that'll get a run in.
Oh, just a great approach there to get him an RBI on the base hit. And with the way their guy's throwing the ball, three runs might be enough to do it.
Now here comes the Arizona skipper up out of the dugout on his way to the mound. And it looks as though that's going to be all for his starter here tonight. So he'll make his way to the dugout after working just 4 1/3, and he just didn't have his best stuff in this one. Daniel Hudson is going to take over here in inning number 5, as it's going to be up to their bullpen to try and keep him in the game here. Here's the third baseman, Adrian Beltre. Smoke toward third. And a sliding try there at third, but it skips by him, a base hit. They're going to extend their lead as the runner scores from second. That makes it a 4-0 ball game. So the base hit there plates their second run of the inning and brings us to our league leaderboard in terms of RBIs.
There you see him, Matt. Third in the National League at the moment in that category. And I tell you, there's nothing more valuable to a team than a guy that hits the ball with authority and drives in runs consistently. He did that right there, and he's been doing it all year.
Salvador Perez is next as he finds himself behind 0-1. One pitch on its way. Just a bit late, and he's fallen behind 0-2.
Salvador Perez is a multiple Gold Glove winner behind the plate, including in 2015, but he can definitely do some damage with the bat as well.
Here's the 0-2. Line to the right side, but this is speared by the first baseman.
Boy, and how they get out of this one with only one out on this play is a mystery. This probably should have been much more than that, but they can't wind up making the play.
Stepping in now, Darren Ruff, as the first pitch to him is off the plate for a ball, 1-0. Runners at the corners, two men out.
Ball
Grounded down the third baseline. And that's a fair ball as this one gets by him at third. And they'll extend their lead even further as the run's in to score from third. Now a 5-0 lead. Freddie Galvis will step in now with three home in the inning and another two men out there on base.
This inning's really starting to unravel quickly from a defensive point of view. This is where you need a nice pop-up in a big way.
The fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one, 1-0.
Oh, he wanted that one. Probably should have got it, too.
Ready with the 1-0 pitch. This one's a strike. It's 1-1. He waits. Now the pitch. And he comes back with a fastball. 1-2 now.
Yeah, you can't afford to be selective now. You've got to expand that zone. Try and put something in play.
Ready to deliver the 1-2. Tried to shoot the corner and he missed it. 2-2. Four pitches. Fast, slow, fast, slow. EK, you thinking fastball here?
It seems to fit the pattern, but you better not get too predictable out there. Guys will catch on quick.
Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. Here's the pitch on 2-2. Strike three, and that'll put an end to a big inning. Another good inning here for the Phillies, and the brotherly love is in abundance now. More in a moment on the show, the Friday Night Showcase.
A.J. Pollock
makes his way to the box to lead us off in the sixth inning.
Boy, they've got some work to do here, but there's still a lot of time left in this game. So just chip away, chip away.
First pitch of the inning is taken low and away for a ball. It's 1-0. Not too many strikeouts on the ledger for him so far, but it hasn't really mattered.
Yeah, I think ideally you'd like to see him miss a few more bats, but as long as you're keeping guys off balance and you're letting your defense help you, you don't need to strike a ton of guys out to be successful.
That one's more like it, he says. Back to 2-1 now.
Well, it's just game one of this series, but you almost have to wonder if they forgot to pack their offense when they got on the plane. It's been nowhere to be found so far.
Ball three. Smoke toward the hole. A diving try, but he can't haul it in. It's through for a base hit.
Back into the stretch for him again as we take a look at his line so far. It's almost like he's kept that shutout going with smoke and mirrors because he's definitely given up his share of base runners. They just haven't amounted to anything so far.
Ender Inciarte will dig in for a third time now. He's popped out and grounded out so far. And he lays off there, 1-0.
All right, leadoff man on first. Here's where you got to start clawing your way back into this ball game. It's not too late, but it needs to start happening soon.
One and oh pitch on the way. Chop foul at the plate, strike one. That nibbled the corner there, but missed 2-1. Nobody out, runner on first. All even now, 2-2. Goes the other way with it as this is in the air down the line in left. Holt will settle under it to make the play for the first out as the runner will have to head back to first.
And with the big lead, he can afford to take a few chances with that fastball. And here, this one works out for him because this is nothing more than an easy fly ball.
Here's Paul Goldschmidt now as he would look at a first pitch fastball for ball one.
Well, you know, if there's anybody in this lineup capable of getting a rally started, this is the guy right here.
Runners on first with one down. And here's a ball lifted high into foul ground down the right field line. And foul. A 1-1 count. Here's the pitch. Oh, and this just jumps off the bat here as this is to deep straightaway right field, and you can pretty much forget about this one. That is a long home run. A two-run home run off the bat of Paul Goldschmidt. Home run number 15 for him thus far, and it's now a 5-2 game.
And if he was guessing up there, he was guessing right because he's all over that thing like a shaggy dog, and he drives it over the wall.
Here's Mark Trumbo now.
Mark Trumbo.
As the first pitch here's a bit high, it's ball one. So after the strong five innings, things have not come as easily for him here in inning number six.
Well, this is kind of the MO of this lineup. They have a way of just wearing you down. And they're starting to get into some better counts to hit, and that work's paying off.
Squared that one up just a little late. Now some action in the Phillies bullpen as a right-hander begins to crank it up out there. Foul right at the plate. The count moves now to 1-2. A little late on the fastball, but he's able to spoil that one off, and he'll get another chance. Looking for the strikeout. Here's the 1-2. Turned on down the line. And he tries for the backhand reach at third, but he gets by the glove down the line.
And things are starting to change for the worse out there. Now, this is a guy who hadn't given up a run until earlier this inning. And now, all of a sudden, he's having a hard time getting anybody out. Looks to me like he's hit the wall out there.
Settling in now, Rafael Vasquez. He singled his last time up. Watches a fastball right there for strike one. On the ground up the middle. That's through for a base hit, his second of the ball game.
They continue to rack up the hits. That puts runners on first and second now. But, as we always say, it's what you do with all those base runners that's important. And so far, they haven't done a whole lot. Just take a look at our score.
Andres Cordero will come forward now. He has flied out and singled so far. First delivery to him on the way. In the dirt. And he's going to make it up to third here as he advances on the wild pitch.
Yeah, and that's always the danger when you're working that off-speed stuff down with two men on base. Once the catcher can't get a handle on it, both guys are off and moving. They're going to move up to second and third now on what will be scored a wild pitch.
And he'll try to hold back the swing, but he'll do so unsuccessfully as that's ruled a strike. You got to say, for a strikeout pitcher, not too many strikeouts here so far.
And he's in a big need of one right here. It would definitely come in handy.
Chop foul over towards the coaching box. Ready on one and two. Takes this the other way to right. That's in there. Base hit. And the run is in to score from third. Now the throw comes in to hold that second runner at third, so they're at the corners now with still only one away.
That's four straight hits against him now, and of the four, this might be the hardest hit of them all. One run will score on the play, and they're really making him sweat out there now.
Here comes the Philly skipper on his way out toward the mound. And that is going to be all tonight for the starter, Yovani Gallardo. So he'll leave with the lead. Can't lose this one, but he is responsible for the two runners out there, so he could get a no decision if they were to come around and score. Ryan Webb will come on and try to get out of this mess here as there are two on with only one away.
Ryan Webb.
Here's Chris Owings now. Low with a fastball here. In the dirt even. It's ball one. Looks like he employed the slider on that last pitch.
Well, maybe you see a little cat and mouse game going between the pitcher and the runner right now. We'll see who wins this duel.
Liner towards second. And that will get down as he delivers a big one here. It's a base hit. And the run is in to score from third. It's now a 5-4 ball game.
Another run home to score in the inning. And it's not going to be charged to him, but still, he's got to find some way to get his guys out of this already.
So striding in, Cesar Hernandez, as he'll look to bring home that tying run from second with a base hit into the outfield. Trying to hold the lead. And that's in there for strike one.
Oh, and you wonder if maybe he decided beforehand just to take a pitch up there first. Too bad for him because that thing was right down Broadway.
And this catches the zone as well. It's 0-2 now.
0-2, you got to shorten up. Find some way at least to put the ball in play. You can't afford a strikeout here with an important run out there at second base.
Got him looking with the fastball as that had some two-seam movement to it. Two gone.
The pitcher number 41.
Well, Daniel, not sure what we're waiting for up there. I mean, these look to be like pretty good pitches to hit, and it just seemed like he never got a really good feel for any of them.
Quentin Berry will get the call here as he'll hit for the pitcher.
Number 53.
This is skied into short left center. Holt has it in his tracks. And that's the third out. Nine men come to the plate. Four score. 9-1-2 scheduled to hit in the home half of the sixth. It's the Phillies 5 and the Diamondbacks 4. Brad Ziegler will come on now as he'll start out the bottom of the sixth.
Number 29, Brad Ziegler.
Jeff Mathis is going to come off the bench as he'll be asked to lead off the bottom of inning number six. Hits the bottom of the strike zone here with the sinker. Strike one. And a curveball's in there, so he's quickly behind, nothing and two.
Yeah, that's a different pitch here, but also on the outside corner. Also taken for a strike. So he's got him in a quick 0-2 hole now.
A little bit off the outside, it's one and two. Gets on top of one here and chops it foul right at home plate. On a good curveball, gets him swinging for route number one.
Well, this curveball, it just disappears. He thinks he's right on it at the plate. And look where it winds up. Completely out of the zone. And that's what you want as a pitcher. You want hitters to chase pitches that aren't strikes.
Here's Drew Stubbs now. As the first pitch sinker misses to him, it's ball one.
That's a pitch you really have to learn to take against a guy like this. But even if you make contact, you're just going to get something in on the label. So that's a great take.
In there, and it's even at one.
Much better sinker there. I think that's the one he wanted to throw to start the at-bat.
Oh, high, deep. That is a moonshot, folks. A long home run. So a solo shot down the line in left. Sixth home run on the season for him, and it's now 6-4.
One more look. See, just a get me over breaking ball. He says, hey, I'll take that. And he sends a long fly ball into the night. And boys, that one's not coming back.
Here's Brock Holt now.
Brock.
As he'll wait out a breaking pitch here that finds the zone for strike one.
Yeah, same pitch here from the home run ball, but this one's in a much better spot down at the knees.
Hit hard on the ground to the right. Oh, what a stop! The throw got him.
Oh, what a play.
Now batting.
On a ball hit like that, if you're the pitcher, you're thinking, oh, base hit. But not this time. What tremendous defense out there. Great diving stop, makes the play and gets the out, and the pitcher acknowledges it, and he's happy about it.
Into the box now, Michael Franco. As the first pitch to him runs a bit inside for ball one. Bases are empty here with two men out. And he misses low with it, 2-0. And a sinker is over that time. It's back to 2-1.
A lot of people think that pitch will burn straight down, but it will work back a little bit towards righties, like that one did right there.
Pitch swung on and hit in the air. Trumbull over to his right. He makes the play, and that'll end the inning. Phillies get one in the frame courtesy of this solo home run. Top of the order due up to start the seventh. It's a two-run lead now. It's 6-4. Welcome back to Citizens Bank Park here in Philadelphia. It's on to the seventh inning now with the Phillies out in front, and it's a good time to check out our game summary through the first six innings so far. Justin DeFreitas is on to pitch now as he'll take over to start inning number seven.
Justin DeFreitas.
Leading off the inning, A.J. Pollock. And they'll need him to get something going here.
Well, you know, he's been on base twice in this one already, so let's see if he can do it again.
A little tardy there. No balls and a strike.
Yeah, kind of a late decision to swing there. Even if he hits that thing, that might just be a routine fly to right.
Swing and a ball chop foul right at home plate. Owen 2 count. Here's the pitch. Protecting on Owen 2, so we'll do it again. Now the 0-2 pitch. Can't quite get around in time to keep it fair, and it remains 0-2. Neither guy giving in here, and they'll do it again. Here comes the 0-2 pitch. Swung on in the dirt for the third strike. And he makes the throw to first. Pollock is retired, and there's one away.
Left fielder, Ender Inciarte.
Ender Inciarte will stand in, one of the few guys not to join the hit parade so far.
Yeah, guys, he's got to be feeling a little bit like that dog that gets left out in the rain while the rest of the family's inside by the fire. I guess he's just not seeing what everyone else is.
And a fastball to start things out here. Not close. It's a ball and no strikes. Downstairs, two balls and no strikes. Bases are empty, one man out. And this one's over at the knees, 2-1. Here it is. And he comes back with a pitch right down the middle for strike two.
Yeah, and even though that's a tough one to get on top of, I think he'd say he got away with one right there. That's in too good a location when the matchup's not in your favor.
And he strikes him out as well. So make it back-to-back punch outs here to the first two men he faces out of the bullpen.
And this is music to a manager's ears here. After he watched his club give up four runs in an inning ago, this guy's come in and gotten two quick outs to start the next inning.
Paul Goldschmidt will stand in again as we flash you back to the middle innings here. This was a big blow, a two-run home run that really got his guys going. Here's the first pitch to him. In tight here with the first pitch fastball that's 1-0. And a good heater as he just watches this baby, a ball and a strike.
Yeah, there's a good one right there, right over the top. You just fire that thing in there.
Two out, nobody on. Hit to third. Throw on to first, gets him, and the side is retired.
Ladies and gentlemen,
Diamondbacks down in order. Score remains steady at 6-4. guy Callahan will get the ball now as he'll take over on the mound to start the home seven.
Guy Callahan.
Striding into the box, Brandon Jordan. He came through with an RBI single in his last at-bat.
Jordan.
And who looks like he got the call there on the pitch inside. It's nothing and one.
Yeah, nice to get that call right out of the bullpen.
Fastball. Whoa, look out. That just about got him in the coconut.
He will definitely give you something to think about up there. There are no comfortable at-bats against this guy.
One and two now as that one's fouled off. Ball and two strikes. Here it is. And a slider runs away from him there, and the count levels at two and two. Tried to bury one down and away, but it's a full count now. Three and two. One thing that man right there will not tolerate, leadoff walks.
Especially right out of the bullpen. This might be a quick outing if that happens.
Crowd gets up for the 3-2. And he gets him to lift one high in the air and drifting out to shallow center. There's Owings to make the play, and that's the first down.
Sometimes when you're throwing 95 miles an hour, you can make a mistake and get away with it. Here, he just can't get on top of this one and winds up popping it up.
Stepping in and ready for another shot, Adrian Beltre. He's looking to go 4-for-4 with a base hit right here. And this one's nowhere close as that bounces to the plate for ball one. Here's the pitch. That one will get out of play, and the count evens up at 1-1.
You know, on May 15th, 2015, Adrian Beltre became the 52nd player in MLB history to hit 400 home runs. He's in some pretty remarkable company.
In front of the changeup, and he can't keep it fair. Two strikes on him now. Ball and two strikes. Here's the pitch. Broken bat as this ball's hit on the ground. And good hustle to get over and tag him for the out.
Boy, that's some movement out there on the mound.
You see that as a righty. He'll naturally fall off a bit to the first base side of the mound, and he just uses that momentum to field this thing on the run and do it all himself.
Here's the catcher, Salvador Perez, as he'll look at a fastball too high for ball one. Bases are empty here with two men out. Looked like a slider perhaps, but it missed badly, and it's 2-0. Two and oh count. Here it comes. line toward the alley in left center. That gets down, and he's got himself a base hit.
Wow, a 2-0 count. And this is a room service fastball. Look where this thing is, right down the middle. I mean, he can't help but jump all over that.
In now, Darren Ruff. As the first pitch to him is a changeup that can't find the zone. It's ball one. A look here at the hits per side here in the late going. Changeup stays outside and he's behind 2-0.
And this is what you got to do up there, Steve. You got to wait him out.
Yeah, and if you can lay off the off-speed stuff, that's when you're going to get your fastball to hit.
A runner on first with two away. And he'll lay the fastball in here to get the count back to 2-1. Pitch on 2-1.
No, that's down.
He's fallen behind now, 3-1. Freddie Galvis would be next if they can keep this inning alive. And a good at bat that time as he lays off for ball four. And as a result, that'll move a runner up into scoring position now with two away.
Oh, you know he wanted that one.
Ready.
Now the inning will continue, and a guy moves up into scoring position here.
Freddie Galvis gets a shot now with two men on and two away here in inning number seven.
And we'll see here if he can come through. It can be discouraging to see opportunities like this late in a ball game go untapped.
Trying to keep the game close. Here's the pitch. And he starts the number eight hitter with a strike. Nothing in one.
And that's what he needed here with two outs. He couldn't afford to fall behind another guy here in the inning. So that's a good job to jump in that driver's seat with strike one.
Two down, runners at first and second. Off the plate, one ball, one strike. Nail-biting time now in that third base dugout.
Well, things are starting to spiral here, and you've got to make sure this doesn't spin completely out of control.
Here it comes on 1-1. And that's high and off the plate, 2-1.
Yeah, a good job here of working himself back into a hitter's count, especially with two men on base in front of him.
Two men are on with two men out. Drives it to deep right field. Back goes Trumbo, but he can't get to this one. It's off the wall. And the run is in to score from second. Now it's cut off. A throw to the plate. And it's in time, and he's out at the plate. So one runs across, but the second one is cut down trying to score.
Posed.
Phillies will have to be content with just the one. We'll look ahead to inning number eight now. Phillies on top, 7-4. Now the skipper's on his way out toward the home plate area, and I believe that means we're going to have a double switch here. Ken Giles will be summoned from the bullpen now, so he'll take over to start inning number eight.
Pitching and batting in the eighth spot. Number 53, Ken Giles. Now playing second base and batting in the ninth spot,
Leading off the inning, Mark Trumbo, as they'll look to get something going here and even this game up.
Well, it's a close ball game, but it's starting to get late, so they need to get at least one back here in this inning.
On to the eighth now, as the first pitch is a fastball that's looked at for ball one.
And that fastball has definitely catches your attention, I mean, especially when it's on the inner half.
Giles sets. Here's the 1-0. Just missing here, 2-0.
You got to think one thing here. Get on base. A walk will do the trick.
To an 0 count and the pitch. A swinging bunt to the mound. Throw on to first in time, so the leadoff man is set down to open up inning number 8.
Yeah, and that's not always an easy play for a pitcher, especially when he has to barehand the ball. But luckily, he's got plenty of time out there, so he's able to set himself and then make a good, strong throw.
Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. Into the box, Rafael Vasquez, as he'll take a look at a high strike that time. It's nothing in one.
And time's getting short here. You don't want to have to face that closer in the ninth inning needing 3 runs. They need to cut that gap down somehow.
One out, nobody on. And it's quickly 0-2. And he'll try and tempt him with one in the dirt, but he'll hold back here. It's 1-2.
Yeah, with the bases empty, that's the right spot for that 0-2 pitch. Make him see if he'll chase that slider.
Here's the 1-2 delivery. Fastball misses in the dirt as he tried to get him to chase the low one. Bases are empty, one man out. Swung on and missed. Two are quickly retired to start inning number 8. Our line score to this point tells the story. You see the Phillies leading this one at home here at Citizens Bank Park as we draw nearer to the end. Andres Cordero will stand in now with 2 away, needing to really get something started here.
And their chances of getting back into this ball game are growing dimmer by the batter.
And he'll try to crowd him there to start the at-bat. It's 1-0. And it's a called strike to even the count at 1.
And when he's got that slider working the way he wants it, it can be such a weapon for him.
And he'll fall behind now to 1-2. 2 out, nobody on. Sent in the air out to straightaway central. And he will make the catch just shy of the track, and the inning is over. So 1-2-3 go the Diamondbacks. They're on the short end of a 7-4 score. David Hernandez is on out of the bullpen now as he'll take over to start the bottom of the eighth.
David Hernandez.
Chase D'Arnaud will stand in now as he'll be getting his first plate appearance in this one here in the eighth. And now some action in that Arizona bullpen as it looks like they'll have both a lefty and a righty up to throw. Now a fastball to start things out. Didn't miss by a lot, but it's 1-0.
And think about it, in game one of this series, they've already had to go deep into their bullpen. This could affect them for the rest of the weekend.
1-0 count, here it is. And he looks at a changeup in there, 1-1. Looked like he was on that one, but it's 1-2.
Well, if he's going to overcommit to pitches like that down in the zone, I'd keep throwing him until he proves he can lay off.
And he lays off a pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2. Outside and a full count, 3-2.
And there you see the leadoff man on deck. And you know they'd love to get someone on base when this lineup turns over.
And this is taken here for ball four. So the leadoff man's on base to kick off the home eighth.
Wow, just a great at-bat right there. Simple as that. Patient, laid off some tough pitches. He was rewarded.
Into the box now, Drew Stubbs. He went deep in his first at-bat. We'll see what he's got in store for us here.
And that was a breaking ball that he hit. And it looked like he saw it right out of the pitcher's hand so nicely. They might have to attack him with some hard stuff this time around.
Right over the top with that curveball, and it's 0-2. Lays off that time, and it's 1-2.
That big curveball is not an easy one to take on an 0-2 count. That's a great job of holding on.
Curveball got him swinging for the first out.
This is just an excellent pitch right here. Location right at the bottom of the strike zone. And if you don't get him to swing through it, hopefully he's going to hit that ball on the ground somewhere and you'll get ground ball outs. But they'll take that strikeout for out number one.
Here's Brock Holt now. Yes, he'll take a look at ball one. And that's right there, and we're even at one.
But this is the thing that's so impressive about this guy. He'll show you that good breaking ball, but then he'll run that fastball up the ladder at 92, 93.
Off-speed pitch in the dirt as he takes it for a ball.
That changeup away is his ground ball pitch. That's a good job to hold off.
Runner at first here, one man out. Runners on the move for second. Hit hard on the ground to second. He's got it. Throw in time at first for out number two.
The batter number seven, shortstop, Michael Franco.
Michael Franco gets another crack right here. He's got a hit in three tries to this point. He's ready. Here's the first offering. chopped foul right at home plate at strike one. Oh, one count. Here's the pitch. On the ground to third. The runner from second crosses the plate. That makes it an 8-4 ball game.
When you're already losing, the one thing you can't do is give away more runs. I mean, you're already in the hole. The last thing you want to do is keep digging, but that's what's happening right here. Things are going from bad to worse now.
Standing in now, Brandon Jordan. He'll take a breaking ball too low, and it's 1-0. Two out here and a runner at second. And a fastball in the dirt that's taken for a ball. Here's a swing, and oh, man! Way out of here! A two-run blast to straightaway right field. 24 home runs for him on the season, as it's now a 6-run ball game.
Right now, this guy could run for mayor of this town and he would win. I mean, he's been as hot as anyone in baseball. His hot streak continues as he launches this one right over the wall.
Oliver Perez will come on now in a mop-up role as he'll just try and keep this deficit from growing any larger.
Third baseman, number 29, Adrian Beltre.
Here's the third baseman, Adrian Beltre. And now a slider in on the hands, and he's lucky that one didn't come and get him.
Boy, hitting the guy wouldn't exactly be the smoothest way to enter a ball game. He's lucky that one didn't get him.
In there, 1-1. Swing and a miss, and it's a ball and two strikes here.
Oh, and he's sure got a good one, doesn't he? That ball goes from about knee-high to ankle-high in a matter of about 5 feet.
To right field and absolutely hammered. Forget about making a play on that ball. It's way out of here. Back-to-back home run. So a solo home run off the bat of Adrian Beltre. Home run number 16 for him on the year, as this is now a 7-run ball game.
Just like the guy before him, he went up there with a very aggressive mindset at the plate. So when he got his pitch, he wasn't thinking, I'm going to hit a line drive. He was thinking, I'm going deep. This ball clears the wall by plenty.
The catcher, number 13, Salvador Perez.
Here's the catcher, Salvador Perez. As this is grounded foul off to the left at strike one. Sinker, one ball, one strike. That look says it all in the third base dugout.
That's not the look of a guy who's going to be sleeping well tonight, is it?
One and one, here it comes. Hit the target, but this is low, two and one. The ball flying around the yard in this one, as you see so far there. A little early, and now it's even at two and two. Four runs here in this half inning. Full count now, three and two.
And that's the right spot for that slider. Really try hard to tie him up inside. And that's a good job to lay off, too.
Ready with the payoff pitch. Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. He's set. Here's the 3-2. Dribbled back toward the mound. On to first, and it's in time as they're finally able to retire him. So four runs in the inning, and they come on the strength of the two big flies. Ninth inning coming up. It's the Phillies 11 and the Diamondbacks 4. Back in the city of brotherly love with Major League Baseball on the show. Chris Owings steps in after hitting an RBI single his last time around.
Chris Owings.
Giles is ready. Here's the first pitch. Drilled on the ground to short. Throw on to first for the out, and that is how the ninth inning gets underway.
And this isn't always the way you want to play it here. I mean, it's late in the game. Your guys are losing. Wouldn't be such a bad idea to take a pitch or two. Instead, he chases after the very first pitch, and it's an easy out.
Cesar Hernandez stands in. Was locked up on strike three in his last trip.
And he was absolutely frozen with a good fastball. So let's see if he's a little more aggressive on that pitch this time.
Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. In tight here with the first pitch fastball. That's 1-0. And that's in there for his strike 1-1. Credit where credit's due. This guy's done a good job out of the bullpen.
No question. He's been able to hold that lead, and these guys really haven't threatened him at all.
Ready to deal. Here's the 1-1. I had him guessing that time as he's barely able to foul it away. Swing and a miss got him reaching. And he makes the throw to first. Hernandez is retired, two down now.
Boy, that's a really nice play there behind the plate. He doesn't panic. He takes his time and makes the good throw on to first. So score that a strikeout with a 2-3 put out for good measure.
Danny Valencia will get the call to pinch hit here as we'll see what he can do with two out and the base is empty. High strike there, 0-1.
I like how he's approaching things here. He's got a good, safe lead, so he's not setting guys up or wasting a lot of pitches. He's coming right after everybody.
Ready with the nothing and one pitch. And a ball popped foul to the right side, out of play. And now the crowd, estimated at over 29,000, come to their feet. Oh, he went for the knockout pitch that time, but a good eye, 1-2.
Well, you know, when you're behind an account like this, it's all about changing your approach at the plate. You got to shorten up a little bit and just look to put the ball in play.
Bases are empty here with two men out. And he'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in the dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2.
And again, they try to take him down in the strike zone just to see if he'll go after that pitch below the knees. But with two strikes, he's been able to lay off that thing now twice in a row.
In the air to straightaway right, Jordan on the move. And he tracks it down, and this ball game is over.
And I think this is a good decision here to let the setup guys stay on to finish this one off. He goes out to...